let us take a look at the actual thermostat itself. We're gonna zoom in a little more so you get a close-up of what we're talking about. So I discussed over here, this is your temperature reading. I will also say that this is just on a one-stage heating setup. This is not gonna show any of the cooling systems because I don't have cooling systems that would work with this thermostat. I have window air conditioners. There's no central air here. But if you look up here, you have the icon, which will show you what you're currently at. So in this case, it is heat. If that was orange, that means that it is actively heating, meaning the furnace is on. Over here, you've got your temperature adjustment. In the middle there, you have just above the big 66 of this is the temperature it's currently at. This is your humidity. So right now we're looking at 38% humidity. Here you would see either eco mode or in this case, the override that I did. We're gonna start over here on the right. This is your Alex A control. So this is where you would set up your Alex A, but you can also click on this to push to talk to Alex A. So you can turn the microphone up top on or off. If you turn it off, there will be a red light that displays for about 5 minutes and then turns itself off. So then you could still use Echo services. You would just have to come in here and push to talk, but it's like two extra steps. You would first have to push this and then push to talk. But if you don't want your microphone listening to you, that's how you can do it. You've got your speaker slider right here, which also shows up when you said, if I was to give it a command and it executed the command, the volume control would also be present there. You can also unlink your Alex A services through the application. And again, a lot of these screens that we're gonna be talking about are mirrored in the application. So reminder that it's over there if you wanna check that out. Next, we're gonna come to our sprocket. This is to override any scheduling that you may have set up. So I can say, I am home for now, or I am away for now. And again, it's letting you know, you can do this via the app. Here is your weather. So again, when you first approach your ecobee smart thermostat, you will see a big picture of the weather, but if you want a more detailed outlook, this is where you can come. So you can see currently it's 39, 0% pollen, 50% humidity, and we're looking at a high of 42 and low of 29, and then it gives you afternoon and then a couple of days, and Monday I'm gonna get some snow, so that should be fun. Next, we're gonna come over here to the hamburger button, and as you can see, because I'm in close proximity of my hand, It's raised the temperature because it's noticed that it's warmer because of the sensors up front. So you've got two microphones right there and then your overall sensor there. There's a proximity sensor, which you may or may not be able to see in the video right there. If you look closely, sometimes you could see a little red light. It's an IR light that kind of shines out to let it know if you're close or not. And then your overall sensors are there. And there it's lowering it because I moved my hand away for a long time. Okay, so hamburger button, we're gonna click on that. This is the heart of your system. Now again, sadly, because I was not around when this was originally set up, some of these I will not be able to talk about, but let's go through this. Up top we have system and we have heat. In our case, we have an HVAC, we can expand that, and heat is either on or off. We're gonna leave that on because it's cold today and I'd like to keep the heat on. Eco plus mode, this is something that was added to the ecobee 5s or smart thermostats, and we'll slowly be rolling out to some of their older models. Now, I will say I wish that some of the explanation that they did in this area, they passed on to the application so it would make a little more sense. So here, if we expand this, we have eco plus on or off. In my case, I do keep it on. Here, we have our savings. In the application, this is a slider and doesn't really explain what it actually does. So here, you can see selecting your preferred eco plus settings, you can select minimum, which will adjust your temperature by 1 degree. Basic, it can adjust your temperature by 3 degrees. Moderate, 5 degrees. Enhanced, 6. And maximum, it can do up to 8 degrees difference of what you actually set your thermostat for. I really wish on the ecobee app that they would explain that to you instead of just showing a palm tree and save more money, save more money, save more money. Explain to me that you will be adjusting my temperature by a degree. I would like to know that in the application. And we're gonna collapse that. And then we've got smart home and away. We will have that listed as enabled. So what that does is it will utilize the sensors and it will follow me. And if I'm in a particular room and I have it set to be in away mode, it knows I'm there and it goes, okay, you're home. I'm gonna turn the heat on instead of leaving it at a colder temperature. So that's our Eco Plus scenario. Sensors, we're gonna click on that. You have up here at the top, Smart Home and Away. This is another area. Is it on? Is it off? Do you have Follow Me mode enabled? In my case, I do have Follow Me mode, so it will use the sensors to determine the best temperature based on the room I am in. And then here you can see the sensors that are included in Smart Home and Away. The thermostat itself does act as a sensor, but you do have that smart sensor that comes with it. And again, you can have up to 32 of those per thermostat. Clicking on our sensor, or in this case, the thermostat sensor, it is participating in Home and Away. I do not keep it for sleep because, like I said, the temperature in my bedroom is 4 degrees colder than out here in the hallway. So this one only participates, the one in my bedroom, only participates in sleep mode. And then you can change the sensor name. So here you can just kind of scroll through that. You can also delete a sensor. Wouldn't recommend that, especially if you're using it. And going back, you have schedule. So this is one of the things that's nice with a programmable thermostat. The older programmable thermostat that I had in my condo, if you're interested, there is a review over there. It's a decent thermostat, but it would only allow you to have 4 settings. Home, away, home, away. In this case, you can see I have sleep, home, away, sleep. And this is only a basic schedule that I chose to set up. You can add more just by clicking up there and selecting home, away, or sleep, and then adding another instance of that. So you can have this be really robust. And you can choose individual days. If I wanted to hypothetically copy this to another day, you can say copy Friday and then select the day that you want to do that to. So if you have specific days of the week that are similar, in my case, just the work schedule between my wife and I, never a day is the same, so I don't use that, but you have the ability to do that if you wanted to. And we're going to go back and come down to comfort, because in comfort, you have home, away, and sleep. Clicking on one of these will allow you to set the comfort temperature, or the comfortable temperature for that. So clicking on 66 will allow me to drag the element up to the preferred temperature for those areas. And then you also see the sensors that are part of that. If you wanted to, you can say bedroom and add that sensor, but we're not going to. And then hit save when you're done. Again, I'm gonna cancel. And you would do that away for away and sleep as well. We're gonna scroll up here. Vacation mode, what vacation mode is? We'll hit this plus sign, and it is I depart on this day, I return on this day, and vacation setting, it will set it for 59 degrees. So while I'm away on vacation, even, you know, if the schedule is set, it will override the schedule because nobody's gonna be home and keep it at this lower temperature. You can change the temperature that you want, and you know, there's your fan run time, here's your temperature setting, so you could fix that as you want. So setting the I depart and I return, what that allow it to do is it will automatically go right into that preferred setting. And then before you come back, it will know and make sure that it heats up or cools off, in my case heats up, your house to the desired, your normal temperature, your home temperature, before you get back. So that's a nice feature. Reminders and alerts. So I have 0 messages, meaning I have 0 reminders, I have 0 alerts. What this is you can set preferences. So here, I have HVAC maintenance, air handler, UV lamp, low temperature, high temperature, and then humidity. And you can also select display them on the thermostat itself, or in the application, it can show them there as well. Again, these are up to you if you want the ecobee to send you reminders for things. Myself, not so much. I do maintenance on my, I will be doing maintenance since this is still a new house, on my heating system once a year. All right, settings and preferences. So up here you've got date and time, 12-hour format or time, so 12-hour or 24, and then you can set your specific date and time there. Preferences. So you've got display, Fahrenheit or Celsius, heat range, so here you could set a specific heat range, device name, can change the name based on that, Alexa, sound disabled or enabled. So I keep this off so it's just a doop sound when it's done listening to me. Screen brightness, this is what I probably spent the most time trying to adjust. So standby, since this is in a hallway and I have to walk past this in the middle of the night if I need to use the restroom, I was adjusting the brightness of this screen because it can be kind of bright. So you've got two, you've got standby and then you have active. What we're looking at right now is considered the active screen. So if you check this, what will happen is the screen will go into a sleep mode during when you should be asleep and not staring at your thermostat. I don't leave that on only because sometimes in a sleep schedule, I may come out and check. Wi-Fi, you can see, well, I have it connected to what I connect all of my IoT devices to, but in here, you would come in here and then you can change. You can select your Wi-Fi network and then you can diagnose if there's problems. So here you've got view log, ping gateway, ping ecobee.com, ping address, and then Wi-Fi. So those are diagnostic style tools that you can use for Wi-Fi. Installation settings, if we come in here, you've got equipment. So you've got wiring. It shows you the wiring as it should be. And it's saying I have a one-stage boiler, which means it's either hot or not on. I'm not going to mess with that one, again, because it's in the middle of the wintertime and I don't want to have that problem. Threshold. So if we come in here, you can adjust a lot of stuff. Again, because I am in a cold time, I don't want to play with this, but you can come in and configure staging, heat minimum on time. It's 5 minutes by default. Temperature correction, I currently have it at 0 degrees, but you could adjust as necessary. Humidity correction, again, similarly. Thermal protect disabled, but right now if I come and turn that on, this is a protective service, which means I can set it for if a sensor is 10 degrees off of what's in the thermostat, it could be told to ignore that. Installer code, currently disabled. And then test equipment. If you are doing this and it's warm, you won't be able to raise the temperature because I installed this probably in August and well, couldn't test it because in August it's not cold enough to run this. So they use that to test and make sure that everything worked correctly. Coming down, we've got advanced controls. Enable security code. So what I consider this is dad mode, preventing anybody from changing any of the settings without first enabling a pin, you know, putting in your pin code. So, and then down here you've got reset, which we're not going to be resetting anything. And last is your about, which will show you the firmware and serial number and some other information for the ecobee.